matter what I do, my hand always shakes writing the check, even though I've got the money in there, just barely. I don't like writing checks for that much money. Well, I don't mind receiving checks for that much money, but I mind writing them.
Hey everyone, today we're talking about groceries, and the question is, how did you, meaning mom, afford groceries in a family like this? 13 sons, one daughter. Anyway, I just wanted to welcome you here. This is, of course, my mom, Cathy Arndt, and I'm Paul, I'm the oldest. This has been something that has been covered a lot on even the TLC show that they did about the family, the subsequent other like news features. They would always focus, groceries is one of the biggest things. So, but just to start things off, how was it in a family like this? Because you were open to a big family, but you didn't know as a newlywed how many children you were going to have. When did you first start noticing that we were different in our grocery needs, or like how we were, that was getting expensive?
Well, you know, of course, as newlyweds and the first couple kids, we were really broke then too. So really, and your daddy's money has gotten better as you guys got.
Yeah.
So in the beginning, the need was there even then. But for us, I first learned about Sam's, and then Sam's has been a lifesaver for us when we were pregnant with Luke, number four. And you know, then you guys were little bitty boys with not that big of appetites. And even then we were beginning to eat in bulk, especially macaroni and cheese and cereals and just a lot
cheese
of things.
Sticks. A lot of just like a lot of like not the most healthy, but we were growing kids and needed a lot of calories.
Yeah, a lot of hot dogs.
Yeah.
And so I was really grateful. That was like such a godsend because suddenly I could get more for a lot less, especially with laundry, soap, and toilet paper. That's a real biggie for us. And milk, all that, it helped a whole lot to find out about Sam's. And I'm not trying to do a plug for them, but for us,
they're not a sponsor, but we really did. Sam's was a big part of our lives.
And it still is.
It still is a great place, even for business supplies and whatnot. But how often would you say you shopped at the very beginning? Or I guess just in general, kind of compressing the years of us growing up, would you say it was like a monthly thing, or is it more twice a month, or how did you do that?
Well, as you guys were getting big and your appetites are really growing, especially as it is kind of tough when you get to teenage years with boys and then having so many boys. And then you guys, I'm very grateful, wanted to get in good shape and have more protein. And that gets expensive. And to get a lot of protein for that many men, young men. Yeah, and so we found that getting chicken in cases was a real big thing. We did frozen chicken breasts. Other times we'd get fryers, you know, a whole chicken, just bake that, kind of like rotisserie, things like that. We ate a lot of chicken. Very rarely did we have beef. And if we did, it was, you know, hamburger mixed with, you know, like a casserole or with spaghetti or something to stretch it out. That was always a big thing, is to find some way to have other things in the meal other than just meat, because you guys probably would have only eaten meat given the option. And, you know, the more I could also have potatoes in there, mashed potatoes or cut potatoes, all gratin, whatever, and then vegetables or something that, you know, made a little cheaper if we could. But we'd get the giant cans, we still do, of whatever we get of vegetables or soups, things like that, sauces. Or what I could make from scratch, we would.
When we were growing up, when you started having teenagers and there were 14 of us, what would a shopping trip look like? Like, would you take the van typically, or would you sometimes take the trailer, or what did it look like going to Sam's?
I would say in our busiest times, in the your guys' height of appetites, we would we were at first just taking our big van. I'd take all the seats out of it except the front two seats and bring a helper with me. Or if I always had kind of that balance of, how do you have a 15-seater van, fit all the food, and have enough helpers to push the shopping carts? Sam's is really big shopping carts, but it usually would take six shopping carts. Yeah. And initially, I just had like my little ducklings behind me pushing shopping carts.
I remember that.
And then
we'd sometimes bump into each other,
and
that's like the worst, one of the worst feelings in the world.
Oh, your ankle! It's
just shredding your Achilles tendon with the shopping cart.
Quite a few hits right there. I almost thought, man, I should wear high tops just to go shopping with you guys, because you'd be distracted by something over there, but still going forward. We waste very little food.
Yeah.
For one, things don't have a chance to go old because they get gobbled down so quickly. we were shocked one time at great grandma's house. She had a gallon of milk that was like 2 months old. And it's like, man, nothing got more than a week old at our place. You know, yeah. It was fresh. That was good if it was still there. But yeah, I would, as I grocery shopped, I would do the left side of the store where the freezers weren't, mm-hmm. and then do the freezer stuff at the end. So the last couple of shopping carts were full of freezer stuff, yeah. and refrigerator stuff. And then we would load up the big van. I always had to think if we wanted to take out all four sets of seats or three,
oh, yeah.
depending on how many guys I needed to be in seatbelts to help push shopping carts, but then I couldn't buy as much. And so I, you know, at one point I finally gave into going twice a month, but having four helpers. And then, you know, I'd have more helpers and I had to have seatbelts, but then I couldn't fit as much.
And what about, I know there's at least, there are at least a few times you took the trailer, mm-hmm. the big box trailer we have, I think yeah. it's like 8x14 or something, but
yeah,
we still have it. We don't use it as much now, but what was it like pulling that? Did you get pretty used to it, or was it kind of an adventure?
Well, I already just driving the 15-seater van takes a little getting used to, but once you're used to that, everything else is easy. I love having the trailer. The trailer is like a giant walk-in closet, so it's wonderful. It makes packing the, you know, whole load of groceries so much easier, but it is a bear to drive because, of course, I can't see out my back windows, and I'm not used to that. And the trailer's wider than the van, as if the van wasn't wide enough and big enough as it is. So I kind of feel like I'm driving a train. So, but it's doable. It's a little intimidating, but I can handle it. I finally learned the tricks to it, but backing up, I still can't do. So I went to a lot of trouble to make sure there was no place I had to back.
It's kind of a brain teaser with backing up a trailer.
It does the opposite of what you think it'll do. It just, and then I can't make myself do something backward.
Yeah,
you know,
intellectually, I couldn't figure it out for a lot of years. And at some point, it just clicked. I did it enough where I just instinctively know what it's going to do. But
yeah.
I almost couldn't write out a diagram of it,
right.
But it's tricky. But
I
admire you that you were willing to jump in there with that giant 15-seater, probably a bunch of kids in tow,
yeah.
and then pulling a big trailer too. But it was practical.
Well, it's wonderful because when we had that big cargo trailer, we still have it. We don't use it for that now, but it was wonderful because I could sort. You know, this big tub is all, you know, cereals, and this is all paper products, and this is all freezer stuff. So I could have some coolers in there to put the freezer stuff in, because it's a good half hour drive to Sam's.
Yeah, something
maybe 40
like that.
Minutes. And so by the time we got back, sometimes the ice cream would be getting a little soft. And but then what we would do is, if it was in the van or if it was also the trailer with the van, we would unload the freezer and refrigerator stuff first and get that load, you know, put into the freezers and fridges before we'd get everything else brought in. Yeah. So.
And I know for me, when I was, you guys were actually eager for me to get my driver's license.
Oh, yeah.
And almost as eager as I was, even though I was so excited, but you know, you're happy to have me go shopping to our local grocery store. I guess I'd sometimes do the big ones too, mm-hmm. but I do remember many times you would like give us a big list, and I would always kind of cringe, especially as a young teenager. Like I had a little phase where I was self-conscious about it. And
like every teenager.
Yeah, and I would read, and I'd kind of look, and I'd say, oh, this isn't too bad. It's just like okay, get like some salt and get some pepper, and then I'd say, oh, 14 gallons of milk and like 28 boxes of cereal or whatever. And I was a little bit self-conscious at first, where maybe for the first few times I would almost like try to subtly like I'll put a few gallons here, cover it with some stuff, and then a few others here. But then really quickly, it just something clicked one day that I was like, well, I'm just gonna be the first one to laugh at it. I'm gonna, because if you act self-conscious about it, then other people are gonna almost like tiptoe around you and won't ask you questions.
Yeah.
And I actually came to really enjoy it, and
just
enjoy the spectacle.
Whether you want attention or not, it gets you attention.
Yeah, you get just the spectacle of, you know, six shopping carts, and I look back fondly at that because it's been a lot of years since I actually did that, so it's pretty fun.
It was always a trick because, of course, we're homeschooling, and you know, that wasn't until we had a second car that I could do that, and then there had to be someone big enough at home watching the younger ones, and if I had a nursing baby, the nursing baby had to come.
Yeah.
And so it was a balancing act, and also I had to have enough money in the account, and I got to where most of the time I didn't send you guys to Sam's because it'd be such a big amount, and I got to where I could keep it totaled up in my mind as I was doing everything. It's kind of like, okay, we're up to 680. Okay, let's see. I've got about this much. Okay, you know, maybe I shouldn't get quite that much meat and get, you know. And so I was constantly adding it up, and I had a pretty good idea what it was going to be each time.
Sure.
And so when we got to the point where we had the big cargo trailer to take with us, that was wonderful to be able to sort the stuff and make it more organized. But what wasn't good about it is one time as I went through their drive up, I don't know, I don't think they had me back up, but somehow it felt like it was too close to their post.
Okay.
And I didn't dare want to back it up. And I ended up having to ask some fella there, would he do it? And he did it really easily, but I was so embarrassed. But
yeah, he's probably happy to help and just...
Yeah, I guess you guys get used to people being dumb like that. But
well, it's just one of those things. If you haven't done it a whole lot, then it is intimidating the first few times.
Yeah, it probably would help if I was doing a little four-wheeler and learned how to back up with that and how a trailer goes with that, something little, and watch you guys do it. But I was busy with the kids, and you guys were outside doing that work.
Yeah.
And I never learned it.
That's right.
And I still haven't.
Well, before we go, I wanted to just give the payoff of the we were going to talk about the amounts, some mm-hmm. of the amounts you saw. You're probably hoping they would be lower, but sometimes we're a little higher than you thought.
Yeah.
So do you want to give us a clue of what do you know the highest total of what it was? Like the highest single shopping total that you remember?
Well, if you say single shopping total.
Not fair if you like, maybe occasionally we buy some other, I don't know, like a one-time purchase. One time we bought a lawnmower, I think, from like a seeded mower. But just for groceries, do you know what's the highest number you remember?
Well, when we were doing TLC, they asked me to, instead of doing all the pickup, the softball classic stuff and the grocery shop and all that, to wait till they came. And so they had me do like 3 weeks of work in 1 week.
Oh.
And because of that, I think total between all the softball classic stuff we're picking up and the groceries, we were well over 2,000.
Wow.
And I was shaking writing that check. It's like the money was there, but I knew I had some money that needed to get to the bank that came for our business.
Yeah.
But I was the one handling the money for that too, and so I was constantly trying to figure out, will it get into the bank fast enough to cover this check, and how long will it take for the check to get there?
Wow.
And that was before we're doing credit cards.
Yeah.
Credit cards give you a little more bumper space, but a check comes out right away.
I think that particular trip, I think there was other media there too, because it was kind of confusing, but TLC was here doing their shoot following the family. It was like an hour-long documentary.
And they filed us for 7 days. Wait, for 7 days or 10 hours each?
I don't know. Okay. I think it was longer, but
7 days for 10 hours or 10 days for 7 hours.
But I think it was. I thought it was 10 days, but
whatever.
Well, anyway, there was also other media. Like for that shopping trip, there was also other media there. I think a few local news stations.
I know.
And so it's kind of confusing because they were buzzing around, trying not to get in each other's shots and stuff. But
I know, and they were asking me questions. You know, they'll have their anchor person or whoever it is, the producer, I guess, asking you questions while TLC was asking me questions while I'm adding up the numbers and trying to think, okay, do I have enough money in the Softball Classic account? And I'm trying to keep you guys all, you know, not wandering off or breaking into the candy or something.
Yeah.
And so, you know, I remember shaking as I'm writing the check. I knew I had enough, barely, but I had enough, and it was good. But it was just like, man, you know, I'll have to make sure after the Softball Classic to get our deposits, give them to the bank so that I could pay our next bills.
Yeah.
And it was running close.
Wow.
And with the Softball Classic, we often ended up not coming out ahead on that, to mention all of our labor.
Sure.
But, you know, it was a bit of a trick. But, it all worked out pretty good. I mean, I guess the most milk we ever bought at a time would be 14 gallons.
Yeah.
Our average grocery bill every 2 weeks from Sam's might be $1,200 to $1,800.
Okay.
But then we'd also do Walmart.
Yeah.
You know, there are certain things that were cheaper at Walmart or cheaper at Sam's, or the Walmart was a lot closer to our house than Sam's was. So, and for a while, oh, it was heaven. Sam's would actually deliver our groceries.
Oh, yeah. That was great.
Oh, that was heaven. I was spoiled rotten.
That was at the old house.
Yeah. And now, of course, we're out in the country, and we don't expect them to come out here. But I think they do some of that now. But
and even,
for close...
That would
People
be nice.
Closer.
Well, of course, now that was way before like Amazon Prime and all the things that we're used to that it get delivered. But that was like early on in the old neighborhood, and it was just this gigantic like semi truck that would show up. Yeah, refrigerator truck. And it would just show up in the middle of the day, and we were homeschooled, and we would just go and unload it, and the neighbors had no idea what was going on. We were bringing in giant
and they'd have big men bringing the food up to the porch, and we just had to bring them in.
Yeah.
And it was funny because I don't know how Mike, Rick's brother, would know it, but he was a teenager at that time. You guys weren't that big. But he would usually happen by right after we got a real big grocery load because he was starving all the time, growing. You know, and you guys adored him. He was so much fun to play with.
Yeah.
you know, so, but he was hungry.
And I have to say, a lot of these lessons you learned over the years from Sam's and just like smart buys and stuff, I think we're still like applying a lot of those today, because even though like guys are moved out and we have different houses, we aren't too far apart, and this is like the headquarters for the businesses. So a lot of times we'll still consolidate certain things. Like we'll say, hey, who's going shopping? Let's put that in the list and then just square up later with the money. So it's really, a lot of those things you learned early on, we're still using now.
So. Yeah, it kind of strikes me funny to see the three of you guys, the three oldest living in one place, and you guys still get cases of toilet paper where you probably could get smaller amounts. But I think you learned from us that, you know, paying 45 cents a roll compared to $1, $1.10 a roll adds up quickly.
Yep, that's right.
And, you know, toilet paper isn't going to go bad. You know,
yeah.
And heck, you could have made a mint on it during COVID.
It was like a currency there for a while.
Yeah.
So.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, I think that wraps up this topic for today. We're going to be doing a lot more of these, and just want to encourage you guys to like and subscribe our channel if you haven't already. Check out FamTeam.com, FamTeam.tv, both of those websites. You'll see more about the family. Yep. See you next time. Mm-hmm.